subject teacher of SST, and today we will discuss the next topic of chapter 2, that is literary sources. And yesterday we had studied archaeological sources, and I know my all the students are very obedient and they study full topic of archaeological sources. I know that very well. So today we will discuss the new topic, literary sources, the last topic of the chapter 2, that is literary sources. Chapter 2, evidence of history. Yesterday we studied archaeological sources. Again, I'm repeating some 2-3 lines. Archaeological sources include artifacts and other physical remains like buildings, graves, tools and other objects used by people who exist in the past. That is called archaeological sources. And who is archaeology? What is archaeology? Archaeology is the study of human activity through the recovery and analysis of archaeological sources. And who is archaeologist? An archaeologist is a person who practices archaeology. Now today we will discuss the new topic, that is literary sources. And a literary sources is anything that has been written. That has been written means in a written form. Literary sources always comes in a written form. The first literary script was in the form of manuscript, which was a handwritten record of the past event, which was actually handwritten records. And manuscripts were written on palm leaves. And palm leaves means palm ka patta, bark of beech trees, and parchment and papyrus and letter on paper. So this was the handwritten material. Literary sources is anything that has been written. The first literary script was in form of manuscript, was a handwritten record of the past events. Whatever events happened in the past, that was the written form in manuscript. Some of them which were written on metal plates, rocks and slabs are still preserved in temple, monasteries and archives. These sources throw light on the social and economic life, the religious belief, practices and culture of the past. Mesopotamian written were known as cuneiform. Egyptian script were known as Hieroglyphics. So in India, Prakrit, Pali, Sanskrit and Tamil were the main languages used in ancient literature. Means in ancient literature, the main written languages was Prakrit, Pali, Sanskrit and Tamil were the main language used in ancient literature. The language of ancient literature was based on the region where it was written. Epics, that the Ramayana and the Mahabharata, were written in Sanskrit. Please underline the sentence. I will ask in your examinations that Ramayana and Mahabharata were written in which language. Then you have to say to me the answer. Epic like Ramayana and Mahabharata were written in Sanskrit language in northern India. The Silapadikaram and the Manimekalai were written in Tamil. These two books are in a Tamil language. So if this was written in Tamil in southern India, means in South India. Literary sources are classified into two categories, religious and secular literature. Religious literature means it deals with all religious writings like the Vedas, Quran, Upanishad, Buddhist, then Tripitaka and Jain Angesis. These contents detail of various rituals, prayer, religions, practices by people in ancient times. If your mama got prayer in front of God, she says some slokes, some dohas, some mantra. Aapki mama mantra bolti hogi in front of God. So these mantra actually includes in Upanishad and Vedas. Vedas, there are four Vedas, Rig Ved, Yajur Ved, Sham Ved and Atharva Ved. So four Vedas includes all the mantra and the process of prayer, the process, the rituals, the traditions, all. So even the Gayatri mantra, we say the Gayatri mantra, that is also included in Yajur Ved, means the first Ved, Yajur Ved. the Rig Ved, actually Rig Ved, Gayatri Mantra, and the Shrot, the Ma Durga Shrot, these all are actually includes in Ved. Rig Ved, Yajur Ved, Sham Ved and Athar Ved, the four Vedas. And Puran and Upanishad. Puran means the written material of the past happened in the, whatever happened in the past. Upanishad, then Buddhist, the Gautam Buddha, all the happened in the past in Gautam Buddha life, that is all includes in Buddhist, and he gave the main Gyan, actually the Gyan of Buddhism. So this is also included in Buddhist, and Tripitaka and Jain, and this is these contents of the various rituals and prayers and religious practices by people in the ancient time, and we also follow the same. Next topic, the literary sources, that is secular literature. It is non-religious literature. It was written with a aim of recording historical events and social administrative aspect of the life of people. For example, Dharma Shastra, then Kautilya Arthashastra, biographic like Harsha Charitra, these are the biopic, means a particular person's and their life happening, the life events, the life whatever happened in their life, these are included in biopics, means biographic. And Kautilya Arthashastra, then who was the writer of Arthashastra, then Kautilya was the writer of Arthashastra. Dharma Shastra, etc. So these are includes in secular sources. These are non-religious and first religious, that is Vedas, Upanishad, Puran, Buddhist, Tripitaka, etc. So these are the religious sources, and secular sources mean these are non-religious, means Arthashastra, then Brahma Shastra, then Dharma Shastra, then biographies, life, etc. So this is the literary sources, the last topic of the chapter, evidence of history. And again, I'm repeating, a literary sources is anything that has been written from. The first literary script was underlined the second line of the paragraph, literary sources. The first literary source script was in form of manuscript, which was handwritten record of past event, means whatever happened in the past. So need to preserve sources. Why we need to preserve sources? क्यों हम sources को preserve करके रखें? क्यों? Why? The archaeologist could give information about the past event because of the material preserved. If it was not preserved in various form, we could not have been able to know any details about the history. That's true. If you are not save your, if you are not preserve your, means last year mark sheet, then you could not able to know that what percentage and what marks you got in previous classes. That similarly, we need to preserve sources, because if it was not preserved in various form, we could not have been able to know any details about the history. So this is the chapter, this chapter is finally completed, and please read evidence of history. And if you have any doubt regarding any topic, then please contact me. I will solve your problem at anyhow. So please read, and please, I just request all the parents, please focus and please concentrate on your children's study, your ward's study. And if they have any doubt regarding any topic, please contact me. I will solve your problem as soon as possible. Thank you very much, students. Have a good day.